Hey, happy Canada Day, everyone. My name is David Ivkovic. I'm the chairman of Canadians Abroad in Los Angeles. We are the largest group of expat Canadians in the world. On behalf of our presidents, Aaron Buckley-Burnett and Zoe Kvorak, we are so excited to be hosting this virtual Canada Day celebration right here in Southern California. Together with our partners, Canadians in Orange County and Canadians in San Diego, along with the generous support of the Consulate General of Canada in Los Angeles. Now, each year, Canadians Abroad hosts one of the largest Canada Day celebrations outside of Canada. And we're super sorry we can't be with all of you today. But make sure to visit our website for future events and for our monthly profile of incredible Canadians, including those working on the front lines of COVID-19 and the Black Lives Matter movement. We're happy that we can still bring you a celebration to your house, and I hope you are taking advantage of our great local Canadian-owned partners who have provided some awesome food and drink specials. They include Urban Press Winery, Republic of Pink Rosé, Ventura Spirits, Joey's Restaurant, and Fresh on Sunset. Stick with us because we have some really cool giveaways and we are excited to celebrate this day with you. Now I'd like to introduce my partners, Andrew and Mark from Canadians in San Diego. Take it away, guys. I'll just be sitting here having some Timbit cereal and washing it down with Niagara ice wine. Just need a corkscrew and a bowl.
Hey guys, I'm Andrew Kapp with Canadians in San Diego. Wanted to give big special thanks to Rob and David for helping set all this up. I was hoping to celebrate Canada Day back in Winnipeg, but San Diego's not too bad of a place to do it. You can always find us on Facebook and Twitter, and hope everyone has a great Canada Day.
Hi, I'm Mark Wortman, co-owner of the Make Good Coffee Company in San Diego, California. Along with Drew Kapp, owner of Kapp Coastal Properties, I manage the Canadians in San Diego group, and we want to wish you a happy Canada Day wherever you're celebrating in California. If you are a Canadian living in San Diego, please look us up on Facebook or Instagram, and we look forward to meeting you at an upcoming event.
Thanks, Mark. I'm Rob Kelly, and this is Tim Noddy. It's been a pleasure working with you and Andrew at Canadians in San Diego and the team at Canadians Abroad this year as we celebrate Canada Day a little differently.
Through Canadians in Orange County, we've been bringing Canadians together to celebrate our heritage since 2009. Our Canada Day at the beach celebrations have been huge, and we also celebrate Canadian Thanksgiving. We enjoy hockey games, baseball games together, and we meet up for happy hours. And we can't wait to get back to that programming once it's safe to.
We invite you to visit our website at CanadiansInOC.com, where we share information about our events and other resources for Canadian expats. We're excited about a great show we've put together, where we're going to hear from Canadians living in Southern California and back home. Now over to Zabe Sheikh at the Canadian Consulate General in Los Angeles.
Hi everyone, this is Zabe Sheikh. I'm Canada's Consul General in Los Angeles, Southern California. It's great to gather with you all virtually, not in person, I know. But whether you're in LA, San Diego, the OC, or elsewhere in SoCal, you'll know that we're here for you and we're here with you. Here to celebrate, commemorate, and look forward. Because let's be honest, it hasn't been a great 2020 so far in so many ways. Recently, we've witnessed protests due to police violence, due to anti-black racism, due to all sorts of inequities and inequalities that our society still has and that our communities still are striving against. Now put together that with the backdrop of a global pandemic, and many individuals that we know have stepped up and risen to the challenge in extraordinary ways. So this year, the consulate is recognizing our 20 for 20, 20 people for their outstanding response. We've invited them to share their stories with you and take a bow. So if you will, I hope you'll watch those in the live stream or later in our social media and share our appreciation with them through what you're watching. So let me say to all of them and to all of you watching, thank you. Happy Canada Day.
We wish we were celebrating Canada Day with you all at the beach as we have for years. but it just didn't feel right bringing a large group of us together of our home and native land, at least at this time.
So during this global pandemic, while we've been practicing social distancing to help flatten the curve, we decided to bring Canada Day to your house via the magic of the interwebs.
And a great thank you to our supporters as well, including Fishbone Bar and Kitchen in Laguna Beach, the Laguna Canyon Winery, and to Crystal Head Vodka, a creation of another great Canadian, Dan Aykroyd.
So, from us to all of you watching at home, cheers.
And happy Canada Day.
Hi, Canadians. My name is Erin Buckley-Burnett. I'm co-president from Canadians Abroad, and this is Clark, and this is Sebastian, and we want to wish you a very happy Canada Day. Thank you so much for joining us. And now, here's two-time Juno-nominated in DDO with a message in performing our national anthem.
May this Canada Day abroad that we are all celebrating in isolation be peaceful and restful. May you on this day, where you honor yourself as a Canadian, you take a moment to acknowledge and to thank the Indigenous peoples whose land we are on. The protectors of the land on which Canada was founded. We take a moment to recognize our complicity in creating an unequal country. And we take a moment to accept that the work will be hard, but we as Canadians, as a diverse people, have the power and the endurance to create an equal and beautiful country, one that is strong. And while it will take work, we will get there. May this day be one full of peace and joy and love. Oh, Canada, our home and native land, true patriot love in all of us command. With glowing hearts we see thee rise, the true north strong and free. From far and wide, O Canada, we stand on guard for thee. God keep our land glorious and free. Oh, Canada, we stand on guard for thee. Oh, Canada, we stand on guard for
I'm Rob Kelly.
And I'm Stephen Armstrong. On behalf of all of us here at Maple Business Council, we want to wish you a very happy Canada Day, which is also the very first day of the new USMCA trade agreement.
We thought celebrating the fifth anniversary since founding Maple last month was pretty special.
But 153 years? Now that's a milestone.
We love our new homes here in Southern California, but we also love our home and native land.
So we're raising our maple cookies to toast Canada.
Happy Canada Day. You're awfully sweet.
Now let's go back to Trader Joe's and get some more of these.
Happy Canada Day. Since we love playing music and singing, we're going to play a song dedicated to all Canadians who are either homesick or can't get home to Canada this summer. A song by Anne Murray called Snowbird.
To turn to green. The snowbird flowers that will bloom again in spring. When I was young, my heart was young then too. Anything that it would tell me, that's the thing that I would do. Tu traverses la frontière à chaque hiver, et malgré la chaleur du soleil, tu gardes un pied à terre. Spread your tiny wings and fly away, and take the snow back with you where it came from on that day. The one I love forever is untrue, and if I could, you know that I would fly. That it only breaks my heart again should I decide to stay. So little snowbird, take me when you go to that land of gentle breezes when your peaceful waters flow.
Canada Day.
Hey, from my farm near Kingston, Ontario, it's Dan Aykroyd. I'm honored to greet my fellow Canadians living in Southern California who are celebrating Canada Day virtually this year. Many thanks to the Canadian Consul General in Los Angeles, Zabe Sheikh, and his team, and hello to Canadians in Los Angeles, Orange County, San Diego, wherever you might be. Thanks for putting this together. July 1st, of course, special day for Canadians all over the world, and I share the country's birthday. So I like to celebrate here at the dock with a couple of my favorite Crystal Head vodka cocktails, and that would be 2 ounces of Crystal Head, 4 ounces of fresh tangerine juice, lots of ice. We call that the crystal driver. Shake it up in a shaker, 2 ounces of the head, or 2.5, or maybe 3. 4 ounces of fresh tangerine juice, maybe 5. Shake it up, lots of ice, and pour it out. Hey, thank you for being Canadian and talking your country up wherever you go. We know how great we have it. Let the world know. All right. To good friends, family, and good health, stay safe. Better times ahead.
Thanks, Dan, and happy birthday. Also, thanks for the Crystal Head Driver cocktail mix. And now for your chance to win a bottle of Dan Aykroyd's Crystal Head Vodka, either in this special edition color called Aurora, or in a Pride edition colored by the rainbow. Be sure to follow Crystal Head Vodka, Canadians Abroad, and Canadians in OC on Instagram. Post photos or videos of how you are celebrating Canada Day at your house using the hashtag CanadaDaySoCal in your post. We'll reach out tomorrow, July 2nd, if you've won. Enjoy your Crystal Driver.
Hi guys, this is Gary McCauley from the McCauley Boys, coming live and direct from our home to yours. We want you to know that Black Lives Matter to us. And moreover, this is more than just a movement. It's a moment in time that has gifted us this opportunity to refresh our collective mindset. A time for us to pause and recognize that we are all one. We love you, and we want you to know that you matter to us. We can only only hope that we matter to you too. Not just as Canadians, but as brothers and sisters, human beings doing this life together. At the end of the day, we are together. Happy Canada Day. We love you. Talk to you soon. God bless. And be well.
Hey everybody, it's Andrew Cole here. Don't let the British accent fool you. I obviously born in Canada, Toronto boy. Just wishing my fellow Canucks in Southern California a very happy Canada Day. And I'm going to play you a song with a very positive message, which essentially, once you dig your way through all the words, means, you know, we should all be one. We are all as one. One people on planet Earth. So we like to believe and so we like to try to be. So lots of love. And you can check out my project, #NoJoke, online. I'll put the link here on the video. So please enjoy my song, Colorblind. And have a tremendous Canada Day. Thank you. We are, we are, we are, we are golden.
Oh man, Americans, they fought a bloody battle for their independence from Britain. Canada, we just asked. We're like, hey, is it like cool if we like go a, you know, if Britain had said no, Canada would still be a colony, you guys. We would not be celebrating today. Oh, I'm excited to be here because I'm in my house, and also to be filming on my camera. I've been doing a lot of shows on Zoom lately, and the last show I was on, I got Zoom bombed. Yeah, it was horrible. I got Zoom bombed. No, wait, I bombed on Zoom. That's what it was. That's what it was. That it was still horrible. Oh, you guys, my name is Renee. My full name is actually Renee Sutra Crystal Percy. Yeah. My parents named me Sutra. Mm-hmm. As in the Kama Sutra. Yeah. Maybe it was cute to name your kid after a book of sex positions in the 70s. I mean, 80s. Oh gosh, we can edit that out. Can we just cut? Okay, 80s. I was born in the 80s, you guys. No big deal. That would be like parents today naming their kid like Michelle Netflix and Chill Douglas, you know? Oh man, this quarantine has been a great excuse to just Netflix and chill though, hasn't it? I mean, unless, of course, you actually have the virus, in which case it's Netflix and chills. Not as fun. That is not a good time. They say that one of the symptoms of coronavirus is loss of taste, and I am currently drinking boxed wine from... One of the symptoms of coronavirus is loss of taste, and I am currently drinking boxed wine from... Just wanted to make sure that I wasn't a super spreader, which... coincidentally, it was also my nickname in college. Just kidding. It was high school. And anyway, family show. I'm kidding, you guys. It still is my nickname. Anyway, the point is, I can't be a Trump supporter. Ooh, that would be terrifying. Ooh. Oh man, it's gonna be weird when this is all over though, isn't it? And you know, we see people again and they're like, oh my God, I haven't seen you in so long because of this darn social distancing. And you're like, yeah, that's why. Mm-hmm. All right, I had to go through so many interviews and multiple applications and I was on a wait list. It was so frustrating, I almost just gave up and adopted a kid instead. Yeah, it was close. Ooh, glad that didn't happen. I'm so glad that you guys are here and celebrating with us today, because they say that laughter is the best medicine, and in this case, I try.
Hi, I'm Arwin Widmer-Bobick. I'm the Consul for Political, Economic, and Cultural Affairs at the Consulate General of Canada in Los Angeles. We are so proud of the Canadians and Friends of Canada who've responded to the coronavirus pandemic in inspiring ways. Whether that's on the front lines, in medical research, or in supporting the community and raising awareness of the importance of staying safe and following official guidelines. For Canada Day 2020, we devoted our celebration to honor 20 outstanding individuals for their contributions to fight the coronavirus pandemic. Here are their stories.
Hi, I'm Natalie Ray. I am originally from New Westminster, British Columbia, and I now live in Santa Monica, California. I am a clinical nurse manager in a COVID-dedicated intensive care unit at UCLA. Since the start of this COVID pandemic, the bravery among our nursing and medical colleagues, despite the fatigue, stress, and fear that this pandemic brings, has truly been amazing. This work is intense, and throughout it all, I have seen incredible teamwork, creativity, and empathy among all our colleagues. And as we continue on this journey, I think one of the most important things that we can do for each other is to be present. This can be an incredibly difficult time for many people. And when we share a feeling of understanding for another person's experience, we let them know that they are not alone. We let them know that what they're feeling is okay and that we will overcome this together. To all my nursing and medical colleagues, thank you for your commitment and your courage during this COVID pandemic. Our nation greatly supports you and applauds your service. Wishing you all a happy Canada Day.
My name is Hans Kierstedt. I'm proud to have been born in Halifax, Nova Scotia, raised on a farm in Uxbridge, Ontario, and I received my doctorate at the University of British Columbia in Vancouver. Today, I am honored to be recognized by the Consulate General as we all celebrate Canada Day. Now, I live in Laguna Beach, California, and I run a company called Avita Biomedical, where we are passionately working on a vaccine for COVID-19. Humanity has never shared a medical mission of this urgency and scope. While news of spread is disheartening, there is reason for optimism. Scientists and medical professionals are collaborating globally to develop and test vaccines and treatments for COVID-19 at a pace that has never been seen before. And while we do, please do your part in following the guidelines of your local authorities to help reduce spread. Together, we can eradicate this global pandemic. Thank you for this honor, and happy Canada Day.
Hi, I'm Liz. I'm a registered nurse originally from Toronto, and now I live in Los Angeles.
And I'm Dr. Pfeiffer. I am an emergency room physician originally from Calgary, living in Los Angeles as well.
We've been working together for years in the emergency room here in Van Nuys. And through this pandemic, we've just tried to make the best of it and keep each other safe.
Yeah, and we hope that everybody also stays safe and that we are honored to be a part of this video as Canadians working here. And happy Canada Day.
Happy Canada Day.
Hi there, I'm Ryan Reynolds. I'm originally from Vancouver, British Columbia. I live in New York City and Vancouver. I'm associated with Food Banks Canada, which is an amazing organization that goes to war each and every day against food insecurity for Canadians from coast to coast to coast. I'm also associated with an incredible organization called Conquer COVID-19, which is a grassroots group of about 100 volunteers founded by Khadija Khadi and Suleiman Ahmed. And they provide PPE for anyone and everyone in need, including vulnerable communities. And I am incredibly privileged and fortunate and lucky to work with these fine and amazing Canadian people and organizations. Happy Canada Day.
Hi, my name is Naomi Seligman, and I'm originally from Boston, Massachusetts. I spent a lot of my childhood in Toronto, and now I live here in Los Angeles. In this moment, and I feel honored and proud to have been able to support some of the people facing the biggest challenges during the pandemic. I'm a communications professional and a mom who suddenly found myself homeschooling our 8-year-old, Sammy, so it came naturally to help the public school systems. I've been working with the County Office Education on planning for the next academic year and connecting county schools with meal delivery companies so children who previously relied on school meals are still being fed. Early on, I was approached by three young New Yorkers who had started a volunteer service to deliver groceries and medical supplies to those who couldn't leave their homes due to health reasons. I helped connect them to sponsors and strategized with them on technology and media coverage. And together, we managed to build out the service from just a few people in a few neighborhoods to a network of over 12,000 volunteers in three states. Thank you for letting me share my response to COVID-19, and happy Canada Day!
Hi, my name is Tim Patz, and I'm the Vice President of Global Marketing for Critical Care at Edwards Life Sciences in Irvine, California. Edwards Critical Care technologies are utilized by clinical teams to monitor seriously ill patients and help clinicians make informed treatment decisions. Now, some of the components of these technologies are also utilized by other companies. In the midst of the pandemic response, Edwards received a call from Linamar Corporation in Canada. Linamar and their partner Thornhill Medical were working urgently to manufacture ventilators in response to the need of COVID patients in Canada. Now, these ventilator systems contain up to 1,500 individual components. I can only imagine the challenge Linamar and Thornhill Medical were facing trying to secure all these parts. We certainly empathize with their challenge, and we wanted to be part of the solution. But at the time we received the call for help, we were facing our own multiple week back order for our components. However, through significant efforts and close collaboration with the Edwards team in Canada, our company headquarters in Southern California, and our global supply chain organization, we were able to expedite the supply of thousands of cables necessary for the production of Linamar technologies. We're proud to be a partner of Linamar and Thornhill Medical as they serve patients all across Canada. And on behalf of the employees of Edwards, thank you for this honor, and I want to wish you all a very happy Canada Day.
My name is Clody Boltzik, and I am an emergency medicine physician here in Los Angeles, originally from Montreal, Quebec. And I hope that everyone is having a happy and healthy and safe Canada Day. I'll be working in the emergency department, but I hope that everybody has a great day, both here in the U.S. and back home in Canada.
Hi, I'm Nia Vardalis, and I am from Winnipeg. I live in Los Angeles, but I will always be a Pegger. In response to the pandemic, I organized something called hashtag Big Fat Donation. This was in memory of my dad, who passed away in March. And what that was is I asked friends and people on social media to join me in donating, and via organizations such as Big Sunday, Frontline Foods, Food for Heroes, we managed to feed over 10,000 meals to frontline workers and their families. The one thing I learned through all of this is just ask. Just ask. It's hard. It's hard for a Winnipegger and a Canadian to just get out there. But I did it. And the overwhelming response was always yes.
Hi there. My name is Scott Phillips with Starfish Medical. We're the largest medical device and biotech device development services company in Canada. But we also have extensive dealings in Southern California. In fact, about 70% of our business is in the U.S. About 3 months ago, we were approached by the Canadian government to develop a ventilator that would be useful for COVID. And so we actually brought in some technology from Winnipeg that originally developed by Dr. Magda Yunus there. And we've just finished with the development. We're ready to start manufacturing with Celestica, which has a worldwide footprint, including actually some plants in Southern California. I'd like to give a special shout out to my friend Mohammed Khandri from the Canadian Consulate in LA, who's been very instrumental in making all sorts of connections for us. It's been super helpful. And I'd like to wish you all a very happy Canada Day.
My name is Aaliyah Jasmine. I was born in Ottawa, the nation's capital, and spent the major part of my life living and working in Toronto for major Canadian broadcasters. I got my bachelor's in communications at the University of Ottawa, go Gigi's, and my master's degree at the University of Southern California, USC, right here in Los Angeles, where I now live and work as an environmental journalist. I have been using journalism to try and tell important stories about how the COVID-19 virus intersects with the environment. Those stories have been broadcast on networks and events, including NBC, Live MedAid, and the United Nations. And along the way, we've managed to raise a little money for Doctors Without Borders, Médecins Sans Frontières, in their efforts at the front line battling this pandemic. As we move into the summer and celebrate things like Canada Day, I urge you to remember that this year will and should look different than celebrations of the past. That's because the pandemic is not behind us. It's so important that you source out credible journalists to get reliable facts and information about this virus and how it's impacting your community, as well as listening to medical experts. Keep wearing masks and social distancing. But whatever you do, as a Canadian, do not let this pandemic stop you from enjoying a bowl of poutine or ketchup chips. And if you get some of those, please send them my way. I miss those ketchup chips. A happy Canada Day, everybody. And thank you so much to the Canadian Consulate for recognizing me. It is an absolute honor.
Hi, my name is Giovanni D'Andrea, originally from Montreal, Canada. Now presently living in Los Angeles, California, owner of Urban Press Winery and Distillery. March 14 was probably one of the most devastating days as a business owner, where everybody was ordered to shut your business down, something that's never ever happened, right? So we had to regroup and rethink of what we were gonna do. And one of the ideas was, everybody lost their jobs overnight, and what we wanted to do was give back to some of the people. So we actually kept our kitchen open. The next day we started handing out free pizzas and pastas to anybody that came by. A week later, we created through my distillery the hand sanitizer products, which we did 5,000 to 6,000, I believe, where we handed out. We had hundreds of people lining up, and we were just handing these out to people that just didn't have to buy anything. We just gave it away. But our biggest joy was actually going out to hospitals and knowing that they didn't have any. I want to wish every Canadian a happy Canada Day and see you guys soon.
Hi, everyone. I'm Anna Innes with Air Canada, and I'm originally from Michigan, which is practically Canada. It's an honor to be part of this celebration representing Air Canada's corporate response to COVID-19. One of the things I am most proud of and from which I learned so much was around our efforts to repatriate so many Canadians from around the globe back home. I think one thing we can all take away from all this is how important community is, not just in our workplace, but in our livelihood and with our mental health. And it's an honor to be part of this community, representing the flagship carrier, which also represents the culture of its people. I look forward to raising a glass in person. Happy Canada Day.
My name is Allison Emilio. I'm from Toronto and I live in Los Angeles. I'm the director of Reframe, a partnership between Sundance Institute and Women in Film. For COVID-19, I launched a short filmmaking competition to help keep women connected and creating content during the pandemic. We raised over $35,000. We received 500 submissions and had over 35,000 votes. The money was donated to the Actors Fund, helping everyone in entertainment, and also to CLA, SEELA, with helping with food scarcity in downtown Los Angeles. So Canada, stay strong, stay true. Happy Canada Day. You have my heart.
Hello, my name is John Chu. Born in Windsor, Ontario, originally from Toronto, and now living in Orange County, California. I work for a food and nutrition company that serves the K-12 school community. And when COVID hit, we were able to still serve the students and the community millions of emergency meals across the country when people were being laid off of work and unable to afford things like groceries to feed their family. It has been a rewarding experience to be able to continue to feed students and many of them in communities that rely on school lunches as their main source of nutrition. It's still a long road back to normal, so keep taking social, take time for self-care, and I want to wish all my fellow Canadians a happy Canada Day. Eh?
Hi, everybody. I'm Deborah DiGiovanni. It's lovely to be here. Happy Canada Day. Nice to be celebrating in your homes. Thank you so much to you Canadians abroad and Canadians in OC, and especially my friend Zoe Kavork. She asked me to do this, and I'm thrilled to be here. I'm thrilled to be, you know, standing. You know, it's nice to use the old bottoms of my feet. You know what I mean? That is... Yikes. I don't have pants on. Don't question it. Don't ask any message. Go around. I'm not going to try. And here's why. I know I'm not going to make it in a Mad Max situation. I cannot... wear leather. I am unable to wear leather. I can't wear leather. You know what I mean? First of all, I'm never getting it off. Do you understand what I'm saying? I put on a pair of leather pants. Those are my last pants. I'm dying in those pants. There's no way. It's very squeaky fabric. It's noisy. Do you know what I mean? There's no way I'm going to be able to sneak up and steal water. You can hear me coming from a mile away. Here comes Deborah. What, what? You know what I mean? Starting fires with my thighs. You know? Yeast infection every other week. Do you know what I'm talking about? Listen. I know. But I am not a doctor. I don't make this up. Do you know what I mean? But we can admit that leather doesn't breathe. Can we admit that? Are you kidding me? That is tough stuff. And why have we made leather so sexy? Have you noticed? Leather's always like so sexual. You see a man in leather pants, you're like, oh my God, look at him. He's ready to party. Maybe he's got a motorcycle. Let me just tell you this right now. Maybe that man has been wearing those leather pants 6 hours. Are you kidding me? 6 hours? There's no airflow in leather pants. If you've been wearing leather pants for 6 hours, that is pretty much the crock pot of clothing. Do you understand what I'm saying? That is some slow cooking, my friends. But I will tell you, the meat does fall off the bone. It just drops off the bone. Very tender, you know. I'd eat it with rice. I really would. Brown rice. I'm trying to be healthy. Now, here's something. It's usually at this point where you start looking at me thinking, this woman has a cat. But I don't have a cat. Surprise. I do cat sit, though, or I used to when the world was normal. Pre-quar, I used to babysit for my friends. And right before this all happened, I was with a cat for 2 weeks. We had so much fun. We talked about boys. We had popcorn. We did a puzzle. It was fun. But I'll tell you, before this, I used to do comedy every night of my life, right? I was out every night. And I didn't know this cat very well. I'm like, I didn't know what he's doing at home. Is he worried? Is he scared without me? What's going on? And then on day 5, I started to think to myself, what if the cat is also doing comedy at home? You know what I mean? What if when I leave the house, the cat's all, what's the deal with all the crying? You know what I mean? God, that one's just for me. You know, these have all been for me. Anyway, everyone, happy Canada Day. Thank you for having me. Be well.
Hi there. My name is Mel. It was my dream to become a Canadian from 11 years old. When I was 25, I got married, and 3 days later, my wife, Susie, and I ended up in Trail, British Columbia, and it lived up to every expectation. I hope you have a wonderful Canada Day. Here's a song by Neil Young. I come down from the misty mountain. I got lost on the human highway. Take my head, refreshing fountain. Take my eyes from what they've seen. Take my hand and change my mind.
To Michael Barber, who's going to tell us about the activities of the Royal Canadian Legion in California.
As Canadians, when we think about the Royal Canadian Legion, many of us think of poppies and Remembrance Day. Some of us watched the national ceremony on television, while others attended a service at a local school or cenotaph. Did you know that there are four branches of the Royal Canadian Legion in California? One in San Diego, two in Greater Los Angeles, and one in the San Francisco Bay Area. As branches, we distribute poppies, hold Remembrance Day services, and march in parades on Veterans Day. We help to organize the annual service of remembrance at Grace Cathedral. We also participate in other veterans commemorations, such as Anzac Day and the Wreaths Across America event. Some of our branches even sponsor local cadet corps.
Hi Kings fans, Austin Wagner here. Just want to say happy Canada Day. Thank you Canada for giving us a gift of hockey. Everybody have a great Canada Day and stay safe.
This is Daryl Evans, a proud alumnus of Los Angeles Kings and the club's radio analyst. I'm wishing everyone a very happy Canada Day. This is a special day and I'm happy to be able to share the moment with our friends at the Canadian Consulate, Los Angeles. I am originally from Toronto, but have called California home for many years. Again, happy Canada Day, eh? And go King!
I'm delighted to be with you. It's Canada Day, wow. And the Giovanna Urban Press Winery. Oh, the wine was incredible. Thank you so much. It's a pleasure to say hello to you guys. See you on the street. I'll wave to you. I'll take my mask off and wave it at you. Have a good time. Bye-bye.
Hockey fans from around the world, this is Sean Pronger, proud native of Dryden, Ontario. I'm at home here in Los Angeles area celebrating Canada Day. Thanks to the Canadian Consulate of LA for helping us spread the word.
To all my fellow Canadians living here in California, I wish you the very happiest of Canada Days. Stay safe out there.
What's up, my fellow Canadians? I'm Sarah Nurse from Team Canada's National Women's Hockey Team, and I was also a silver medalist in the Pyeongchang Olympics back in 2018. I just wanted to come on and say Happy Canada Day. I hope you guys are having an amazing time and doing a lot of celebrating. Hope to have you back on Canadian soil soon, and I hope you have a Happy Canada Day.
Hi there! Happy Canada Day! Erin Karplak here, just sending you so much love and light today as we take this very essential pause. I hope that you and yours are happy and are healthy and staying as sane as possible. Right, babe? Yeah, I know. We will. Happy Canada Day!
One, two, Happy Canada Day, everybody!
Hi, I'm Natalie Ray, Clinical Nurse Manager in the ICU at UCLA. From all of us Canadians working on the front lines, we want to say please take care of yourself. Stay safe and take all the proper precautions. Have a happy Canada Day, and we look forward to celebrating with everyone in Southern California.
Hey guys, my name is Renata Fast. I'm a member of the Canadian National Women's Hockey Team and a 2018 Olympic silver medalist. I just wanted to send a message to wish you a very happy Canada Day. I hope all the Canadians abroad can enjoy today and have some time to celebrate our amazing country.
Hey guys, it's Laura Vandevoort, and I wanted to wish every single Canadian in California a very happy Canada Day.
Hey, hockey fans, this is Derek Armstrong. I'm in SoCal celebrating Canada Day in conjunction with the LA Kings and Canadian Consulate of LA. Hope you guys are enjoying the festivities and having a great day. Oh, Canada!
Hi, guys. Happy Canada Day.
Happy Canada Day.
Okay, I'm just going to do the talking right now because this is like our 10th take because he keeps screwing up, and we're just supposed to say Happy Canada Day, and we're sorry you guys can't have a really big party.
Happy Canada Day. I'm Stefan. And this is Michelle, and we're in Toronto right now, and we're wishing that everyone there is staying safe and is having a good Canada Day, and that we're thinking about you.
Yes, we are. Appropriately.
Maybe next year we'll be there.
Okay.
Bye.
Bye.
Hi, guys. I'm Tara Macri, and I am celebrating Canada Day in a beautiful backyard. I want to wish everyone in California, everyone in Canada, and everyone in the whole wide world a very happy Canada Day. This song is called This Crush because I have a crush on Canada. I'm completely into you. So let's get high, high above the clouds so blue. Don't think about coming down. Don't think about more than here right now. Don't think about anything but sha-na-na-na-na. Cause this crush goes up like it's never coming down. If it gets a little rough, so let's rewind, cause I can't seem to get enough. Don't think about coming down. Don't think about more than here right now. Don't think about anything but sha-na-na-na-na. Cause this crush goes up like it's never coming down. And I feel it like you're honest. Happy Canada Day.
And now a quick message from Canadians living in Southern California and across Canada from coast to coast.
Nous sommes deux femmes à Hollywood.
Et nous célébrons la fête du Canada.
Wishing you a happy Canada Day.
Oh, Canada, terre de nos aïeux, ton front est sein de fleurs en glorieux.
Car ton bras s'est porté l'épée, il s'est porté la croix.
Ton... En fait, moi, je pense que j'aimerais bien pouvoir chanter, si ça ne vous dérange pas.
Mais là, il faut que tu chantes, donc toi, tu vas pas chanter.
Non, mais je peux juste dire quelque chose à la fin, genre, pas oublier de chanter.
Ben, comme quoi?
Ben, je sais pas, des vœux, genre.
Oh my God! OK, ben, bonne fête du Canada!
Happy Canada Day!
Bonne fête du Canada!
À tous les Franco!
Santé!
Chin chin!
Hi, I'm Katie Boland, and happy Canada Day. I am so grateful to live and work in the States, but I will always be so proud to be Canadian.
Happy Canada Day!
From Jasper National Park.
Happy Canada Day, California, from Glencoe, Ontario, Tim Hortons.
Happy Canada Day, California, from Canada, obviously, where there's free healthcare and poutine, sort of free healthcare. We're just visiting. We still have to pay for enemas like you do. All right, happy Canada Day. Be well, be safe.
Bye.
Bye.
Happy Canada Day, California. Happy Canada Day!
Happy Canada Day, friends, from Yosemite. Feels like home in amongst all these beautiful trees and clean air. Sending all my love to my friends and fam across Canada, Southern California, the US of A. Cheers, everybody. This may or may not be water. Might be some Crown or some Labatt, who knows. Bye, have a great day.
Hey everyone, I'm Jessica Kelly here in Orange County, wishing you a happy Canada Day at your house.
Thank you.
When these restrictions are behind us and we can get back in the air, we hope that you'll fly the airline that carries the maple leaf. Air Canada has been a great partner of Canadian expat organizations for years. And I'd like to introduce you to Anna Innes, National Manager of Business Development and Community Engagement for the U.S. Over to you, Anna.
Thank you, Rob. You know, every year Air Canada loves partnering with Canadians Abroad LA, Canadians in OC, and Canadians in San Diego. Together, these groups represent thousands of Canadians living abroad, and we all share the mutual goal of supporting this expat community. I know it's been a strange year, and we're all very eager to be reunited. At Air Canada, we put in place biosafety protocol measures to support a safe experience. So when you're ready to travel, we'll be waiting for you. Which brings me to the free tickets. If you want to enter to win a pair of tickets to Canada, post a picture or video on Instagram, and please do tag Air Canada, Canadians Abroad LA, and Canadians in OC. Use the hashtag CanadaDaySoCal. Again, hashtag CanadaDaySoCal. And we'll message you tomorrow, July 2nd, if you're the winner. Thank you so much, everybody. Happy Canada Day.
Anna, thank you for your support. That was awesome. We really appreciate what you and Air Canada do to support us here.
And thank you to Canadians everywhere and the Canadians in California who were able to enjoy this program as well.
Thank you for the support of the Canadian Consul General in Los Angeles and for our partner organizations, Canadians Abroad and Canadians in San Diego. We hope you guys have an awesome Canada Day.
Happy Canada Day.
Hey.
Hey.
Thanks for watching, everyone. We are so glad we got to share a piece of Canada with all of you. Thanks for having us in your home. Your new drapes look fantastic. And we can't wait to see you at the next event. When Tim Hortons Roll Up the Rim to Win says it's safe to do so. Make it rain ketchup chips, enjoy your Caesars, and happy Canada Day. Ooh, that's a lot of sugar. Ooh.
Thank you for joining Canada Day at your house. We hope you enjoyed the program. And now we'd love to connect with you in the way so many of us have over the past couple of months. Please join us on Zoom right now and bring your favorite Canadian drink and snack, and we'll keep the celebration going. If you don't already have the Zoom app, you can get it at zoom.us. That's ZOOM.US. Then join us with the meeting ID 861-0851-7835 and use the password 1867-1867, the year of Canada's birth, twice. See you on Zoom.